Good morning. It is a joy to be with all of you in worship this morning. Welcome to Calvary United Methodist Church. A special word of welcome for those of you who might be visiting with us for the first time. Let us pause for a moment of prayer as we prepare ourselves for worship. Lord God, as we gather this day, we open our hearts to you, seeking your healing and transforming love. Give peace to our racing hearts. Bring love into our lives. Help us be those who will bring justice into the world. We have gathered here to sing our praises to you, to celebrate the fast approaching coming of your Son. Grant us joy this day as we celebrate in anticipation of the birth of Christ. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Turn it over to the praise team now, who will lead us in some worship together.
Good morning, everyone. Just a couple of announcements. If you are visiting with us today, in the pews, there's a piece of paper. We'd love to have your contact information and any prayer requests that you might have, prayers of joy, prayers of need, and that's for anyone, and we can get you on our mailing list. Also, there are cards for our Christmas Eve candlelight service. Please take them for your friends. And we also know that it's a time when many people come into our church, perhaps for that only time during the year. So if you're sitting beside someone you don't know next Sunday evening, introduce yourself and invite them for 2018. And now if you'd rise, if you'd like, for our first song, He is Exalted. Driving along the road, there are people asking for donations, and this is a wonderful packet with socks and all kinds of good things. So please take it, keep it in your car, pay it forward to someone else. And as you know, we never can have enough cookies in this church, so we think we have plenty, but we're really not sure. So we would love to have some pretty cookies between now and our Christmas Eve service. They can be dropped off at any time during the week here at church, or women are going to be plating next Saturday morning, so it'd be nice to have them by then. And now, our second piece is You Bring Peace.
You're the light that shines in the darkness. You you'll please join me in the call to celebration? Now from the house of David, a child of grace is given.
For a Savior comes among us to raise us towards the heavens.
Now from the home of Mary and Joseph, a child of love is born.
For a Savior comes among us to guide us towards the needs of our human family.
And to lead the feet of pilgrims along the path of peace and goodwill.
So let us bless our God with songs of faith and acts of faithfulness that will never cease.
Now, if you'll please join us for our first hymn, I Want to Walk as a Child of Light, number 206.
Take a moment to shine that same grace and gracefulness with those who gathered with us this day for worship. Please let us greet one another with a Christmas gift of peace and greetings.
part of the candle lighting?
Changing it.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm doing that.
If there are any other young worshipers who'd like to join us up front for our children's message. I want to ask you a question. If I said sticks and stones, who would know what I was talking about? You would. What am I talking about? Being hurt. Sticks and stones. How, does anybody know how it goes?
Oh. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but no, words never hurt me.
Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. How many of you have heard that before? I'm going to let you in on a secret. It's a lie. It's not true. I have been hurt by words. Have any of you had your feelings hurt before by something that somebody said? We can use our words to hurt people, but did you know we can also use our words to help people? What are the ways we can use our words to help people?
You can say something kind, give them a nice comment.
You can say something kind, give them a nice comment, yeah?
The bones say got scary.
One more time.
The bones got scary.
Oh, okay, something's scary. Are there ways we can use our words to help people? I like the idea of saying something kind. The Bible verse that we're going to read today says we can encourage people, which is to say nice things. So I have a challenge for each of you. And if you need help, Miss Liz and I are going to help you guys out. But I want you to encourage people. So I want you to all go out and find two people, because if you look out there, that looks like a group of people who are in need of some encouragement. So we are going to encourage them. So if you can each find one or two people to encourage, say something nice to them, and then we'll come back up front for a short prayer. If you need help, we'll help you. And if you need to think of something to say, you can just say, God loves you. That's a very encouraging thing to say. Everybody okay with that? All right, go find somebody to encourage. Encouraging, you can find your way back up to the steps up here. You guys are doing such a good job. This is awesome. All right. You finding your way back up? You all did such a good job with that. So I want to offer a prayer to encourage you guys, and then Miss Liz has an announcement. So will you pray with me? God, we thank you for your love and that you love us. Help us to lift each other up with our words and encourage one another. In your name, amen. Miss Liz has an announcement real quick, guys.
All right, well, just in case you somehow missed it, Calvary's Christmas party is today. We're going to go downstairs for lunch, and then right after lunch at around 12:30, we're going to come upstairs and have a party. So young kids, kids at heart, whatever you want to call yourself, you can come out and have fun. Santa's going to be here. We're going to get presents, cookie decorating, crafts. So come on out if you have time.
Thanks, Liz. During the Advent, we've been taking time to light our Advent candles, and we've been asking different people in the congregation to come forward to assist. But today I'm going to switch gears a little bit. I've asked if Matt and his family, because many of you maybe have not met Natalie yet and their son Desmond, so I've asked Natalie and if she would come forward with their son and allow them to light our candle today, because you didn't get a chance to see Matt as dad or husband always. We're always up front. So thank you, gang. Mark from the choir, I think, is going to lead us through the litany.
Please join in the singing from the bulletin insert. During Advent, we wait for the coming Savior, who is our Prince of Peace. The Lord gives strength to his people and blesses them with peace. In the midst of conflict, we look to the one who brings harmony. The Lord gives strength to his people and blesses them with peace. In the midst of confusion, we look to the one who brings clarity. Gives strength to his people and blesses them with peace. In the midst of division, we look to the one who brings unity. Strength to his people and blesses them with peace. In the midst of separation, we look to the one who restores the broken. Today, we light three candles. The first candle reminds us of our hope in knowing Jesus as our wonderful counselor. The second candle reminds us of our joy in proclaiming Christ as our mighty God. We light the third candle to remind us that Jesus is our Prince of Peace. In a world filled with conflict, tension, and discord, we look for the peace that comes through Christ alone.
Now please join in singing our prayer hymn, Lohau, a Rose Era Blooming, number 216 in your hymnal. Thank you.
Each Sunday we have quite a list before us in our bulletins of those that have asked for prayer or that we are aware of. Today is no different. But I do want to add these items during our joys and concerns this morning. One joy is the opportunity that we celebrate with Church Union at Daily Bread to help our homeless neighbors. This past couple of months, it's expanded to even add more of an opportunity for those individuals who find themselves living on our streets to have a pause, a break, a moment, if you will. And so the past month, I want to give a special acclamation to Reverend Bob Marvelli, who's leading that program on our behalf, who has made it possible through special donations now to have special Steeler Sundays. I don't know why. Have you heard of the Steelers? I think they play not too far from here. But believe it or not, with a large screen TV, snacks, and an opportunity to stay warm, over 130 of our homeless neighbors last 2 weeks have had an opportunity to watch a Steeler game and to be in a moment of celebration like many of us. I'm even told that some of the people hollered at the screen just like I do during the game. Now, I know that may sound minute to you, but not to the people that don't have that opportunity like we do. And also this month, we've been gathering certain gifts, if you will. On the altar today, as part of our offering and blessing, are some of those gifts. Please take note of what you might wish to bring over the next few Sundays and place them at the bases of the two trees in our sanctuary. Special needs for gloves and sweatshirts have been added to our list, as well as I referred to it, our Keep It Brief gathering. So please take note, the next couple of Sundays, you can bring those things even after Christmas, the couple of Sundays into the new year. They'll be distributed throughout the next month plus. So please take note of that special offering in our time of prayer. Finally, I want to add a name. I was called yesterday, Karen James. Karen and Sarah, of course, have been connected with our congregation for years, even though now they've moved to the southwest of our country. But Karen's mother, Eleanor Natalie, is in Presbyterian Hospital after a stroke, and she asked if I would mention for special prayers this coming week. That's for Eleanor. I believe that's all that I had. Is there any others I may have missed? Mark? The first name of a friend of Mark and Mike's, Rodney, with a potential heart attack suffered just last night. Keep Rodney in our thoughts and in our prayers. Let us now pause and let us pray together. Jim, if you would, sir, lead us in the unison prayer.
Unison prayer in our bulletins and on the screen. O gracious God, most merciful and mighty, fill our hearts with joy and our souls with praise as we continue the journey of hope towards our Savior's birth. Enable thy spirit to be among us as we remember the mystery of his birth and the power of his life. Stir up in our hearts the precious gift of faith that he may be born anew in us and that his presence may be seen in our lives, proclaiming to all that Christ is born again. Amen.
May we continue in the spirit of prayer. Gracious God, we light a candle each Sunday of Advent, but throughout the year, we light candles every Sunday. And in these moments of prayerful connection with you and with one another, we ask that in our prayer time, we would also be lighting and sharing those candles. So Lord, this day we celebrate and give you thanks for the opportunities we have to light a candle for those that find themselves homeless, like Mary and Joseph that first Christmas. Help us to continue throughout this year to share that light, to provide food and care when it's possible, and a kind word whenever we have an opportunity to see or to speak to someone who needs some light. And Lord, we give thanks and also ask prayerfully that you continue to be with us as we seek to share that light with those around the world. not just with our prayers, but with opportunities of special offerings and gifts to assist. As we have this past year in cases of disaster in response to those disasters, as we have with a special church in Texas, we ask, Lord, that you would continue to call us and guide us to prayerfully share that light with others around our world in a time of need. And Lord, we think of our own family here at Calvary. When tragedy strikes, whether it be of health concerns or whether it be in the form of unemployment or a crisis and disaster itself, may we continue, Lord, as we have this past week, to help families after a fire or families after a crisis in health. Enable us, Lord, to always remember that the people whom we are also very close to have those challenges as well. They may not be in the news, they may not be mentioned in broadcast or in social media, but they are written upon our hearts. Lord, remind us and continue to call us to share your light with those closest to us. And Lord, we think of our own lives, how there are those moments of darkness, those moments of depression, those moments of unaware, unassured, those moments where we fail or fall, and we need a little light. Lord, we prayerfully ask that you would continue to help those around us to share your light when we are in need. So in this coming year, Lord, as the forefront of this sanctuary proclaims to love you with all of our heart, soul, strength, and minds, and our neighbors as ourselves, as we continue to light candles in this Advent season and on Christmas Eve, when this whole sanctuary will be of a warmth glow, let us be reminded of our prayerfulness with you and therefore with one another in sharing that light. In thy name, we ask of this and we pray. And would you lift your voice with me this day and let us share our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen and amen. We have a special opportunity today. I'm going to ask if you would take out from your packet this morning the reception into the United Methodist Church. We have a few new members that are here this morning, and one of them is a very new member. I'm going to ask if they would come forward at this time, and others who wish to join with Calvary's Faith family at this time, please come forward.
The Church is of God and will be preserved to the end of time for the conduct of worship and the due administration of God's word and sacraments, the maintenance of Christian fellowship and discipline, the edification of believers, the conversion of this world. All at every age and station stand in need of the means of grace which it alone supplies. The questions of faith, Matt?
Shelley and Jamison, I'm going to ask you a couple questions. They call to mind the creeds of our faith. Do you, in the presence of God in this congregation, renew the solemn vow and promise made at your baptism?
We do.
Do you truly and earnestly repent of your sins?
We do.
Do you believe in God the Father?
We believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
And why not let us all join them on the next two answers?
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
We believe in Jesus Christ, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead, and on the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead.
And you believe in the Holy Spirit?
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and of life everlasting.
Do you receive and profess the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testament?
We do.
Do you promise, according to the grace given to you, to keep God's holy will and commandments and walk in the same all the days of your life as faithful members of Christ's holy church? Will you be loyal to the United Methodist Church and here at Calvary support and uphold it by your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness?
Brothers and sisters, I commend to your love and care these persons whom with this day receive in the membership of our family of faith. Do all of you in your power to increase their faith, to confirm their hopes, and to perfect them in love. What saith thee? I've asked if they would do the honors, Matt, of introducing the newest member who hasn't even been baptized yet because 3 weeks old?
3 and a half.
Oh, who's counting? Come on.
This is Jasper Sterling Rohr. He was born November 21st. So.
We're here. We're here. Why not just share one thing? By the way, when you're a member of this congregation, you never know when I'm going to pick on you. What brought you to Calvary? I mean, what brought you here?
We were looking for a church that we felt we could grow our family in, and we looked on Google and came up with this church and decided to try it out, and been happy since we...
And you came back.
We came back.
Would you please join me in welcoming our newest family and our church family? A couple other reasons to celebrate this day before our offering. I need to remind you that we have a number of families who are sponsoring us this month to match whatever we gift. So whatever you place in the offering plates between now and the end of this month of December will be doubled. It will be matched. So please remember and keep that in mind as you think about your gifting possibilities. I also want to make it an important announcement. Linda mentioned it earlier, to invite people on Christmas Eve. Well, next Sunday, Christmas Eve, service will be at 11 o'clock, but Christmas Eve will be at 7:30. The CME Church, the Church of Our Savior, are both joining us in the evening next Sunday for Christmas Eve services. So I'd recommend that we invite and see if we cannot have one of the largest worship gatherings. It's our 124th consecutive Christmas Eve. The first one was held in 1893 in this congregation. That was the very first worship service of this congregation on Christmas Eve, 1893. So that's next Sunday, 11 o'clock in the morning, as well as 7:30 in the evening. Finally, a thing to share today. As we share our gifts, I'd like also for you to consider taking one of the packets that's in front of the Christmas trees today and sharing that with someone that you might see on the street this coming week asking for help or assistance. I keep them in my car, ready to roll down the window and hand to a person, and I've received nothing but great thanks and accolade for caring enough to be prepared to share.
So please, take one or two of them. We still have two major containers up here. Keep them in your vehicles and make it a possibility for you to share this coming week. Let us now gift our tithes, our offerings. Would you please stand with me?
As you have done it unto one of the least of these, you have done it unto me. It is written, Lord. So this day at thy altar, not only are we reminded of the special gift that you've given to us, but we are here too to share these gifts with those around us. Lord, we ask your blessing upon these gifts and the gifters. May they both continue to be strengthened. May those that would be shared with our homeless neighbors and those finances that will continue the ministries of our congregation, with your blessings, continue to share the presence of the baby Christ in thy name. And everyone said, Amen. Please, you may be seated.
Thank you, choir. Thank you so much. Today, our text is taken from one of the many letters that the heart and hand of the Apostle Paul wrote to those in Thessaloniki or Thessalonica, depending which seminary you went to. But the text is from the last chapter of that book, and I've asked Jim if he would do the honors today. Sir, would you please?
Today's reading is from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 12 through 28. But we appeal to you, brothers and sisters, to respect those who labor among you and have charge of you in the Lord and admonish you. Esteem them very highly in love because of their work. Be at peace among yourselves. And we urge you, beloved, to admonish the idlers, encourage the faint-hearted, help the weak. Be patient with all of them. See that none of you repays evil for evil, but always seek to do good to one another and to all. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Jesus Christ for you. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise the words of the prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good, abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your body and your soul and your may your spirit and your soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. Beloved, pray for us. Greet all the brothers and sisters with a holy kiss. I solemnly command you by the Lord that this letter be read to all of them. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
The word of God, written by the people of God, for the people of God. Thanks be to God. It's recorded that the year was 1843. It was 174 years ago, if you can do the math quickly. Sir Henry Cole from England, Great Britain at the time, had commissioned a young man who he had hired as part of what they called the Public Records Office. Now we may call it the Post Office. You see, John Horsley was an artist, and when Sir Henry Cole hired John, he was unaware of his special gift. But that holiday season, he decided to ask John about an idea that he had, and it was an idea that he was hoping would save time from writing individual letters and cards during the Christmas season to all of his friends. So he thought if he printed up one card, sure enough, it might save him a lot of time and send out a Christmas greeting. Well, as they say, the rest is history. In fact, the very first Christmas cards went out in the late 1840s at 1 cent equivalent in the US. And if it did not have an envelope, it was a half a cent per card. By the 1880s and 1870s, it became so popular that the Public Records Office had to hire so many people at Christmas time just to send out the cards. Here in the US, it was 1875. Louis Prang. He happened to be a German immigrant, a printer. He actually started a contest of artists for Christmas scenes to go on, you guessed it, Christmas cards. By the time this church was being built, the 1890s, there was over 1 million Christmas cards that went out across this country. And if you're wondering, it was 1915 when John Hall and two of his brothers really started to produce Christmas cards at a level unforeseen before that time. And if you're not familiar, John Hall and his brothers, that's Hallmark. And by 2010, get this, 1.5 billion Christmas cards were sent out. 45% of all cards by 2010 brought Christmas greetings. Now, over the years, there are many different forms of Christmas greetings that you're aware of, I'm sure. Carols and carolers, all different kinds of music, traditional as well as more contemporary. There's a multitude of songs these days that can bring Christmas greetings. Outside decorations, oh my goodness, there was a time they were not as prevalent, but that seems to have gone to the wayside, and they're becoming more and more prevalent again. Special places to go and see the Christmas lights. But also, there are plays and movies, perhaps some of my favorite. You may hear ringing in your ears George Bailey running down the streets of Bedford Falls, hollering Merry Christmas and bringing greetings to the old bank and to all the other scenes, or Tiny Tim sitting at a table. God bless us, one and all. You know, the scripture today is not one of those traditional texts. In fact, I could not remember in over 40 years of ministry ever having that text in an Advent. I mean, come on, there's no angels, there's no shepherds, there's no wise men. Joseph and Mary aren't mentioned. In fact, Jesus' name is only mentioned twice, and it's almost as if it's a benediction. And yet, if you're very careful and you take a moment to really listen and hear it, the Apostle Paul is writing his final notes to a group of people that he has become to love and to know. He hasn't seen them for some time, and he doesn't know if he will ever see them again. After I read this week, I have come to believe that this could be one of the best Christmas greetings ever written. I mean, let's review. To have respect and love for one another, to be at peace, to encourage the faint-hearted, to help the weak, to be patient, to do good, to rejoice and pray always, give thanks, hold fast to what is good, and keep your spirit, your soul, and your body sound. Grace be with you. Sounds like a Merry Christmas to me. You know, it's funny how our brains work, at least the one that I've been given. It doesn't always really function in recalling what happened yesterday or what I'm supposed to do today. But then you have these little clips in there from things that you saw years ago. Why? I don't know. For instance, this week, for some reason, there is this little piece in my mind about All in the Family. For those of you that aren't familiar, Google it. But Archie and Edith were the two main characters in this sitcom. Archie was far from what I would call a decent person, and Edith, in the midst of her gifts and talents, seemed to find the way. In this particular adventure, Edith is at her high school reunion, and I can remember it in details. She encounters a classmate named Buck. And unlike earlier years, Buck had put on a few pounds. In fact, he would be called obese today, excessively overweight. But Edith didn't seem to notice that at all. They went on to have this delightful conversation, laughter, wonderful memories, a big hug, and a wonderful, wonderful conversation. But in the very next scene, Archie, isn't Buck a wonderful person? Archie's response, you're a pip, Edith. You and I look at the same guy and you see a beautiful person and I see a blimp. Edith pauses. And you know in her little high squeaky voice, yeah, ain't that too bad, Archie. You know, as a preacher, I've often wondered if I had been there that first Christmas, would I have noticed anything different? You know, those everyday opportunities that we face, would I have seen or heard? Or would it have been business as usual, getting the list done, getting everything completed? Would I have noticed any difference in the stars or heard anything different in the heavens? Would I have helped the Holy Family? Or would have I been like Archie? You know, Reverend Leonard Sweet is a gifted preacher He's been the dean at Drew University over the years and continues to do quite a bit in preaching. And Leonard and I have had a chance to be together periodically, and so I always watch what he's doing. And he shared a little story this week. He said it was a gray Friday in 2007. It was the peak of the morning commute. And there was a young man who walked into the train plaza in Washington, D.C. He opened his violin case like others do throughout the week. He threw in a few bucks just to prime the pump. And then he stood there on the side of that very active train area and started to play. But this was no regular guy. His name is Joshua Bell. He is one of the renowned violinists in the world. And the violin he took out of the case was not your normal Stradivarius, to be specific. And you can guess what happened. Did people stop in their tracks? Were they mesmerized by the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity? Joshua Bell, just 2 days earlier, had played with the orchestra. It cost $200 a seat. And here he is on the train platform. For 3 minutes, nothing happened. And he was recording this. In fact, you can probably Google and see part of it. A lady finally threw in a dollar. 6 minutes later, the first person stopped to listen. After 45 minutes, one of the greatest performers of our time, on one of the greatest instruments ever made, in 45 minutes, he had gotten $32.27 donations. And you know what Joshua said later? He said, well, I got more than minimum wage. John Lake, in his book, Timeless Beauty, The Arts of Everyday Life, I will now quote, if we can't take the time out of our everyday lives to stay a moment and listen to one of the best musicians on earth, play some of the best music ever written, on one of the best instruments ever made, if the surge of human life so overpowers us that we are deaf and blind to something like that, what else are we missing? If we don't take the time out of our everyday lives to stay a moment and listen to one of the best musicians on earth play some of the best music ever written on one of the best instruments ever made, if the surge of modern life is so overpowering that we are deaf and blind to something like that, what else are we missing? You know, I believe that our simple text today speaks to everyday life, and it brings a Christmas greeting unmatched by any card or any other form that could be created. It speaks of respect and love for one another. It challenges us to be at and to find peace, to encourage the faint-hearted, to help the weak, to be patient, to do good, to rejoice and pray always. Rejoice and pray always. Give thanks. Hold fast to what is good. And keep your spirit, your soul, and your body sound. Grace be with you. Well, I think it's a great Christmas greeting. I hope you do too. Amen. Let us stand and let us sing our final hymn of the day. And the congregation proclaimed, Amen. I want to make a note here today. Doug Lucas, who's the head of our food ministry here at Calvary, asked me to share with you that, of course, today there's a fellowship meal like there is every Sunday for everyone who's here. But next Sunday, Doug wanted to do something special on Christmas Eve. Next Sunday morning, after worship, he has told me that there will be a full Christmas dinner, turkey, all the sides, dressings, and so on and so forth to go with it. So next Sunday, there may be an extra reason to be in worship, thanks to Doug and our food ministry team. And you may want to thank him when you see him today. Let us receive the benediction. Gracious God, as we go our separate ways with our separate list of things to do and the opportunities to celebrate and to remember this season, as well as all the secular things around us, Lord, we ask that we remember to take the light of this place, the light of your place, the light of your presence, and wherever we are, in whatever place we find ourselves to be, remind us who we are, whose we are, and whom we seek to celebrate this Christmas and every day. May the Lord go with us. May the Lord's face shine upon us. And may the Lord be with us until we meet again. But we also may we find ways to be with our Lord until we come together again. Go in peace. Amen.